meant for an adult audience. LoveLine may contain sexually oriented content. Content. Listener discretion is advised. Adam Carolla and Dr. Drew.
LoveLine, coast to coast.
Hey, everybody, it's LoveLine. I'm Adam Carolla. That is Dr. Drew. Phone number 1-800-LOVE-191. Dr. Drew, board certified physician, addiction medicine specialist. System of a Down is going to be in here tonight. At least our old friend John from System of a Down and possibly our old friend Shavo from System of a Down will be in here tonight. They had to do a in-store.
They were mobbed, apparently.
Well, I could imagine, because yeah. There's a lot of fans outside of the radio station tonight, so I would...
Just give us one of those again.
I would imagine that there was a pretty good crowd.
Yeah.
Wherever they're doing their in-store. So those guys are trying to get out of their in-store and come over here, and I'm sure they'll be here momentarily. In the meantime...
Yeah? No power.
No power. No power. The Corolla house.
There's the horrible winds here in Southern California.
Yeah, it's really windy, and the power kicked off. And it's really just, first off, it's a couple of things. The power... It was. I live up in the canyon, and really just whistles through that canyon like a mother. I mean, you just stand up. You. Two things that always run through my head: why aren't these windows just breaking? Mm-hmm. And secondly, why aren't those trees falling over? Sometimes they do, but I go to bed at. I usually go to bed about 2:15 with a little buzz on, and it's about 5:30 in the evening when
tonight.
Last night. And I'm sorry, 5:30 a.m.
Oh.
A couple hours after, 3 hours or so after I went to bed last night. And my wife starts shaking me in bed.
Uh-oh.
And I got the earplugs on, so and I got my buzz on.
And you got
so
your lovey shade.
Got my lovey shade on, so I'm all hunkered down. And this wind's blowing like hell outside. And she's like, "What's that? What's going on out there?" And I'm like, "What are you talking about?" And I hear sort of in the other part of the house, although I'm not sure what part of the house. I hear, like, what the hell?
Oh, my God.
What the hell's going on out there? And I'm, "Hey, big man voice, big booming.
Like on the street or is it in your house?
It's coming from within the house.
Oh, my God.
Coming from within the house. And they're just screaming in there. Hey, Shavo.
Shavo.
How are you?
We're hearing a story.
Sit on down.
Sit down, relax.
Shavo, System of a Down, is in here. Where's John?
You should have been here.
All right. Well, he'll be here then. So, yeah, sit on down. Put the headphones on, Shavo. Turn the cell phone off.
Yeah, we're hearing a nighttime story here.
Yeah.
So far, it's been real good.
Well, now I know Drew didn't see the movie.
The Shining.
No. I know you didn't see that. But I know you didn't see The Ring, too, which is the...
Psychotic movie, by the way.
New psychotic horror movie. Did you see the movie The Ring?
Yes.
Good. This is perfect timing then. So, as I was saying to Drew, the power kicks off in my house about 5 a.m. last night, unbeknownst to me.
Oh, 5 in the morning, it had gone off.
Gone off.
You didn't know it, though.
Didn't know it. Right. And then at 5:30, my wife wakes me up, tells me there's someone in the house. Because I'm hearing a big, strong male voice that's kind of going, hold on. Hey, Anderson, I can't. My headphones are a mess in here.
And you guys, you kind of have a cavernous house. You know what I mean? It's like, I think it's echo and...
Yeah.
These big cement walls and wood floors and stuff.
Castle.
Yeah. I got this big... Anderson, my headphones, buddy. All right, let's see. Hello? All right.
Alia.
I'm just going to get past it. So I'll put the headphones up over my head.
You can plug them in over here if you want.
All right, you want to plug them in over there? All right, so I'm hearing this big booming male voice coming from inside of my house. And, you know, all chicks do... Let me tell you something about chicks. Not only do they not take care of the problem, they fuel the problem. Who is that? What's going on? There's somebody down there. Now, see, if you're just alone, you're processing. You're thinking, man, the TV's on or something. Yeah. Something's going on.
Right.
But, you know, the woman, if you have someone who's next to you scared, you're going to be more scared.
Oh, yeah.
She's like, there's somebody in the house. Go down there, check it out. What's going on? And I'm just hearing this voice come from the living room. And so... I start creeping down the stairs, and I'm seeing a big glowing light that's coming from the living room because I just got a new flat-screen TV, and I've ascertained that it has kicked on. It kicked on when the power went off and then came back on again. It kicked on this flat screen TV. Why? I don't know. There's no other TV in the house is turned on, but this new possessed flat screen TV is on. And there's just a big booming male voice. Like if I was hearing a McDonald's commercial come from it, I'd have a context or some Fullerton Dodge commercial five in the morning would have been fine, but just this big male voice. Now, I just got done seeing the movie The Ring on Sunday night. That movie was about a television. Basically, the TV kicks on, and you're dead within a week.
7 days. Yeah.
Yeah. There's many scenes where the person's sort of in their house and they hear a noise coming from the other side of the house, and they come walking up.
Just spoil the movie for
everybody. Yeah. Well, I'm not gonna ruin it, but they come walking up to the TV and the TV's on.
Yeah.
And they're like, I didn't turn this TV on, and now they're going in 7 days. So
Poltergeist.
24 hours later, my TV is blasting, and it's a big scary. Now, as it turns out, it's a guy. It's like an evangelist. Who's on there, which are always, they're almost as scary as clowns are out of context, you know what I mean? Because it's 50-year-old guys with big voices, and I'm just hearing, and he said he bequeathed to John, and John begat Hezekiah, and the devil rose from the earth, and I'm like heading down the stairs like half stone, thinking about the movie The Ring, and kind of freaking out, and then I just stand in front of it and look at this big scary guy, and I shut up.
How could it be on without power?
Yeah, Drew, all of the things that are going through my mind, by the way, as I creep down the stairs. And the only way it could be on without the power, no, it kicked on when the power came back on. Power came off,
I see.
Power came back on,
I see.
Kicked it on.
I see. So you're,
but really, the only reason it came on is because I saw the movie The Ring 26 hours earlier. Because I lived
stuck
around.
Stuck his arm out of the
yeah,
TV, right?
And got me by
and
got me by the neck. I mean, I've had TVs my entire life. I've never had one go on in the middle of the night, except for one day after I saw a movie about a TV that comes on.
That's
and
wild.
people die, you know. Mm-hmm. And of course, it's not 1:30 in the afternoon. It's 5:30 in the evening. It's pitch black. Wind's blowing like hell.
It's in the morning.
Yeah. Morning. Sorry. Yeah, I mean, it's middle of the night for me, okay. and it's in my living room,
crazy.
Which acoustically is kind of weird. And I got the sound all the way up on that one TV set. Because I was skipping some rope and watching it 2 days before, and I had the sound all the way up so I could hear it because the rope makes a lot of noise. So I was completely freaked out. And then, like I said, the wife, they don't help. You come back and Ben's like, why was the TV on? I'm like, I don't know, power surge. Remember in The Ring? Yeah. I remember that. The TV came on and people died. Yeah, I know. But why would it go on and none of the other TV? Yeah, I don't know.
I got a different thing with my wife. She kicks into action. I'm literally trailing behind her. Then she gets her ass in a sling and starts freaking out. Then I'm supposed to come in.
At least she goes down there. At least I just send her out
kicks.
And lock
Boom.
The door behind her. All right. So, hey, Shavo, what's happening, buddy?
Relaxing. Trying to...
Power's out at my house, by the way.
Still
so
is?
In a bad way. Bad way.
It still is out. Okay. Mm-hmm. Not mine. I was afraid of that happening in mine, but it didn't do it.
I may be coming home with you tonight, Shavo, because you know how long it's been since I've seen TV? I'm almost
got a big TV too, so we can sit in front and
cuddle. I'm
watch
like,
a taboo too.
I'm at like 22, 22 hours without TV at this point.
Well, for you, it's not TV, it's porn.
Oh,
right?
True.
Right?
Yeah. Speaking of porn, where's John? He's going to be here?
See, John's a porn fiend.
Oh, we know that.
Yeah, he's got to be bringing me my Taboo 2 on DVD, perhaps.
Oh. Has it all. Yeah.
Oh, man. There they have it.
How was the in-store?
It was good. It was tame. It wasn't that crazy.
Oh, okay. So you guys got out of there unscathed?
Yeah, and then I went to Hot Wings and ate.
The new CD is called Steal This Elm, and it is out today as we speak. And then what are you guys doing? You're going no scheduled tour dates.
Nothing.
Why not?
Because we're going to chill and take some time off each other and do some of our own stuff and then maybe do a little tour and write the fourth record.
All right, so you're going to write, but don't you got to come out with a tour when this CD comes out?
You don't have to do anything, really. I mean, we're
really?
Just going to do this our way, and we don't have a video for it yet. We don't have nothing. We're just going to release the album like we did and see what happens, you know?
Are you going to direct the video when you do the
video?
I'm
not sure, maybe. I'm thinking about it. I might have someone come in and help me out with it, someone with a different, fresh mind, because I'm so involved with the band that I might want to... Second perspective.
But last time we were in here, or you were in here, you were talking about videos and directing.
No,
and
I'm going to do a lot of different bands also.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I already have like three other bands that I'm going to be doing January, February, and stuff like that. So.
Yeah. Because remember how impressed we were by Shavo's video direction?
Absolutely.
Thank you.
Yeah.
No, I'm still going to be doing it. It's just I don't know if I'll do the next system video alone because I want someone else's view on our band and his, you know.
All right.
So that's why.
All right. We'll hear something off the new CD before the night is through. And I see a call up here wants my cranberry sauce recipe.
You want to do that now?
Well, I should give it out tonight. I was going to give it out tomorrow night, but I realized we're in a day delay.
Someplace. I was going to wait until John gets here because he's so into food.
All right, Tony?
Yeah.
You're 26?
Yes, sir.
What's up?
Not much, man. I was having sex with a girl about a year ago, and I didn't know if she urinated on me or if when she came she dispersed fluid.
Hold on a second.
Johnny boy.
John is here.
Hi, buddy.
I think he's got taboo too on him.
He's got something.
Yes, he does. Yes, he does.
That's why he's late. He went to. Wait, I gotta see these pictures.
Get away from this.
Forget the question. Forget the. Dropping a load.
Sorry, I'm late, guys. I had to go back home to get that for
you. Oh, John has got Taboo 2 for me on DVD. Let me tell you something. This is the greatest gift I've ever received.
Hey, why'd you flake on me?
John, you didn't call me.
We weren't supposed to call. I told you Thursday we'll see each other. And I went there. And luckily, I had somebody with me. Otherwise, I would look like an ass.
John, you said, John's talking about, we were going to go,
for the presentation of the Taboo 2 Award.
Oh, really? Really? Well, John, first off, I'm sorry for the misunderstanding. But secondly, I talked to you like on a Friday or Monday or something. You said, yeah, I'll call you. I'll call you. And then you didn't call, so I didn't think you were hip.
No, Drew looks right at the back, not the front cover.
Yeah,
the back cover. He wants to know the story.
No, I've heard so much about this.
By the way, what's going on in this place?
What? It's different. There's a tunnel outside.
Oh, through a tunnel. They're doing a little rebuilding outside.
I had to get on like one of those Disneyland Pirates of the Caribbean things. The water and, you know.
The clock is
on. Is this the happy family here?
That's mom and dad and Junior and the sister.
Yeah.
All right, so Drew, don't soil it up.
Well, I'm just.
And do you realize if the power's not back on when I get home and I got Taboo 2, I'm gonna have to go down to like Sam's and rent a generator and just hook it up to the DVD player. Oh, Drew, I may be coming over. No. I may be coming by.
Did you tell me Ron Jeremy was in this or something?
Is he in this?
I don't think he plays a part in that one.
He's in here.
Junior's the guy is the perpetrator,
right?
All right,
true, please.
Ron's not in.
Ron is highlighted in the orgy scene.
Is he not in Taboo 2?
Yes, he's in there.
Oh, that's right. I forgot about
this. This is the orgy scene. He's not there.
Well, look, you can't see.
You're
him.
Right. You're right.
But he's in there.
I don't see his little belly.
It's not the best scene in the movie, so it's not really that
doesn't stand out in your mind.
Yeah. Well, I enjoy it.
This girl's cute right here, John.
All right, so I'm going to be taking Taboo 2 home tonight, but I swear to Christ, if I don't have power in my house, I'm going to have to break open the DVD box and like hold the thing up to the flashlight and try to beat off. I'm not sure how it's going to work out, but
you have that portable DVD player.
More than brother and sister,
but lovers. It doesn't have a charge on it. It's got to be charged.
Do you have the car charger for it?
You can drive it down the road, stay on there for half an hour while it recharges.
Oh, I see. I'll just plug it into the cigarette jack of the car.
Yeah, that's right.
Get the AC
adapter. Just go sit in the car, in the garage.
All right. That's
Dorothy LeMay. Is that her name?
All right.
She's hot.
You know, let's get off the subject. All Hi, right. Grandpa and Grandma.
Yeah, yeah.
Thanks for coming. Thanks for coming to L.A.
Well, visiting and listening to the radio.
John and I, we're gonna go out and eat a little.
Are they listening?
Little lunch, but we got our wires crossed. But John, anytime.
Yeah, I had a great lunch though.
I'm ready to go.
Ordered the full meal.
That place you took us to?
No, I went to the counterpart that actually makes the sandwiches that I like.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right. So where are we? We're good.
We're still talking to Tony.
Oh yeah, Tony.
Start over again.
Sorry there, buddy. What's
up? All right, man. I was having sex with a girl, and she blew all this fluid all over me when she had an orgasm.
Right. Mm-hmm. That happens. That
happens all the time. I was telling my roommate last night, and he started laughing at me, telling me that she probably peed on me.
Well, there is such a thing as that. But usually it's not that. Usually it's just some fluid that comes out of the glands down there. And that's a normal thing.
Well, you got a table saw going back there?
No, I'm machining.
What are you machining?
Motorcycle parts.
Uh-oh.
Yeah.
Yeah, but what kind of machine is that?
It's a Fidel vertical mill.
Oh, Jesus Christ. Yeah, what are you doing, custom bikes?
No, just custom, like, frames and and fenders, stuff like that.
Yeah, all right, good time.
Middle of the night.
I know.
Yeah, what time is it over there?
It's just after midnight.
Wow.
You guys just ended last night's show with Sum 41.
Oh, great. Yeah. All right.
Can I ask a question for your system?
Yeah.
All right, big fan. You guys sound like you're real spiritually motivated, and I was wondering where that motivation came from. Like, do you guys have a certain religion that you follow or anything like that?
That would probably be a better question for Serge.
Oh, yeah?
But we're the Taboo 2 guys.
No, actually, I don't follow a certain religion that's written in a book or anything, but I follow my own higher power, and I think that's pretty
right on,
spiritual.
Dude, that's cool.
So, I mean, that's the only way I could go, because I can't believe in something that's written by a human, you know?
Yeah.
But now you guys have lots of sort of family values and things like
yeah,
that.
Yeah, we're supposed to be Christian. Like, Armenians are born Christian. Yeah. You know, I have been christened, and we all have, I think. But I don't practice it the way that Christians should, I guess. Because
haven't been circumcised, though, you know, I just found out.
You haven't
year
been.
Ago.
He just found out, he says.
Really?
I had no idea.
Well, you think what that's the kind of stuff you talk about first day of band practice.
What happened to Jim, like in high school? You didn't.
I don't remember.
Who's
really
Jim, dude?
Naked that often in the gym.
Wow.
Hey, who's Jim?
I don't know. Do you know something I don't
know? We should have known that you were.
I was trying to suppress that memory.
Hey, Tony?
Yes, sir.
All right, there you go.
Right on, man. Thanks.
All right, good times.
Yeah, you too.
And apologize to your neighbors, would you, once in a while?
I will.
Got a guy over there.
Or make him something.
Welding bike frames at midnight. And you know those biker guys you're scared to talk to?
You don't go up.
Like,
biker meets metal.
They're blasting Leonard Skinner, and you hear an arc welder going all night, and it's like, it could be goddamned if you're going to go over there and tell ZZ Top to cool it. All right, let's talk to Zelda, who's 19. Zelda?
Hello?
What's up?
Nothing much. Hi, System of a Down. How are you?
Hi, hello. Zelda. How are you?
I'm good. I have a question for Dr. Drew.
Yeah.
Okay, Dr. Drew, my hair is turning white, and I have no idea why.
Like all of it, or just in spots?
Just the roots are coming out white.
The roots are coming out white.
I mean, the rest, I have black hair, and then all of a sudden, my hair just started coming out white, and my parents don't know, so I've been hiding it from them. I've been wearing, like, hats, and I've been dyeing my hair, so. And I don't want to go to a doctor, and I don't know what to do.
What do you mean?
Wait a minute.
Roots
if the roots white, isn't the hair white?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's coming out. That's what I'm trying to say.
What I understand what that means coming
your
out.
Your hair's
it falls
changed.
Out?
Your hair's changed color.
Yeah, there you go.
That's what she's trying to say.
All of your head, you're turning gray.
Yeah, basically.
All right. Well, that's
can't that happen if you get really a bad scare?
Yeah, it's just premature gray. It happens. It's just one of those things. You have a medical workup to make sure there's not anything else going on.
Your hair stands up when you get scared.
Right, right.
Only if you're black, actually.
Okay.
I gotta work. But Shavo. What happened to Shavo.
There's nothing specific about it, and you should be worried about it. I'm a little confused, though. Do you pull the hair out and you see white?
Yeah. I mean,
it's supposed to just turn
tendency.
White altogether, right?
Yeah, but everybody's follicles are kind of white.
Yeah, I have a tendency of pulling my hair a lot, so also.
Yeah,
I
but see. Zelda, I think you may be obsessing about something that's not even happening.
It is happening. I mean, do I have to take a picture or email it or something? Because it looks nasty.
But when you pull it out of your head.
Yeah.
Are people commenting on it?
Yes.
Who's your friends?
Yes, they're like, "What's wrong with you? You look like a effed up child of the corn or something."
Really?
Yeah.
I like those friends of yours. Don't you go see, who should she see,
just
Drew?
Just a general doctor.
Soon?
Just
regular doctor.
That's it. It's no big deal.
All right?
Are you sure? Okay.
What happened to Fidel? Did he die of hepatitis or something?
Got
where
old,
is he? Got old?
Yeah.
He was married, wasn't he?
Yeah.
Didn't he seem gay?
Yeah.
You can't say Sassoon. You can't say Sassoon without sounding gay, can you? Try to say Sassoon and sound straight.
Sassoon.
See?
He's gay.
Can you try to, really, it's an impossible name to say in a straight way.
Sassoon.
No.
That was gay.
That was like sassy.
Yeah.
Don, 15.
Don?
Say Sassoon, Don.
Oh,
say anything.
Sassoon, sorry.
Lesbian, you hear that?
No, I'm a girl.
What's going on?
That's right, you can't be a lesbian.
Yeah, it'd be mathematically impossible for a girl to be a lesbian. Go ahead, Don.
Whatever. So, wow, I'm really glad I got through.
Us too, baby.
I've been, like, I waited 6 months for this because I spent all night on hold the last time John and Shavo were there.
Oh, really?
So yeah.
You just want to talk to those guys?
Yes.
Here they are.
Well, okay, John, I met you at Ozfest in Phoenix. I traveled like 200 miles, like went all the way from New Mexico to Ozfest just to see the guys from System of a Down. And like, I don't know if you remember, but like, I like saw you through a crack in a fence and you signed my jeans. You don't remember, do you?
Yeah, I kind of do remember, actually.
You do?
There was a couple of my friends there, right?
Huh?
There were two of my friends there at that time, weren't there?
Well, you were on your cell phone.
Oh,
he was okay. Talking to two of his friends, though.
Yeah, well.
Right.
Well, yeah, and like, we like looked through a crack and like, you put your face there and like, it was really cool.
Hey, let me interrupt for 1 second, Don, sure. And say this. You guys noticed that when you're talking on your cell phone, people understand you're doing something, but it's not exactly like a phone call.
Right.
Like, if I'm pumping gas and talking on my cell phone and somebody pulls up to the next stall, they're like, hey, Adam, what's happening? I'm like, hey, doing good. You know, you do that nod, that cell phone, like I got the cell phone doing good. And they're like, hey, what's up with the man show? And you're like, hey, it's cool. What about that kid who sells beer? It's like, what part of the cell phone don't, like, the people, it's got to have a cord on it or they don't really fully understand.
Then
it.
They get a little angry when you kind of close them out and turn back to your phone call.
I'm just saying, people in general do not respect the cell phone as if it's an actual phone call that's going on. It's sort of a phone call, but no way.
Yeah.
Like, if you were in your office or your room talking on the phone and someone walked in, they'd give you the finger like, oh, okay, hold on. No, I'll be back. And they'd shut the door behind them. They wouldn't stand in your office and start yapping at you, right?
Not only would they not talk directly to you, they wouldn't talk out loud to someone else next to you.
Right. They'd leave you alone. Yeah. But that cell phone, you get chicks trying to get you to sign their jeans through a crack in the fence. Society has no respect for the cell phone, Don. Am I right?
All right, Don. What else?
Don, say Sassoon. Say Sassoon.
Sassoon. Okay. But the thing is, I did just kind of ask him really quietly, discreetly. I do respect him.
Okay.
Because we also met Darren, but that was.
Okay, babe, what's wrong? Are you freaked out?
What's going on now, West?
Am I freaked out? I'm talking to two of the greatest men on the planet.
Thank you, baby. What about the band?
Oh,
thank you, baby.
No, like I ran to the record store after school to steal this album.
Thank you so much.
I've been like waiting for it forever, and like, I just wanted to tell you guys, like, Shavo, when I hear your music, sometimes it makes me cry.
What about Shavo's video directing? That's pretty impressive, right?
Yeah, I mean, like, I don't know. Like,
what about Taboo 2?
Taboo 2? I wish I could watch it.
Yeah.
I'm waiting for my 18th birthday so I can go out and rent it.
Well, I'll tell you, if the power is not on when I come home
you're
tonight,
going to her house.
You're in New Mexico?
Quick drive to Phoenix.
What is that?
New Mexico.
That's a short 11 hours.
Yeah, 11, 12 hours, yeah.
I could make it. I'll just gas up the Z.
Gas up the
Z. Yeah, it was like, me and my best friend, Alicia, we spent over $180 and went all the way to Phoenix just to see you guys.
Wow.
Yeah, we didn't care about anyone else that was there at Ozfest, just about you.
Did you guys have a good time?
We had the best time.
Well, that's awesome.
Like,
okay. What was that? That sounded good.
I'm shaking. Like, I'm so excited. Like,
well, say something so we can say something back to you.
What do you mean?
What do I mean? You're moaning.
All right.
There you go.
Do you think it's bad that I buy like 3 copies of every magazine that you guys are in and I plaster the pictures on my bedroom wall?
And then what do you do?
That's healthy.
Oh, I know what I want to talk to you guys about.
All right, that's enough. She's been on hold. She's been yapping for 5 minutes.
Thanks for calling.
She didn't respond sufficiently to my cell phone.
6 months
either.
She was waiting for this.
That's all right. And she got extra airtime.
She got her licks in. System of a Down is here. Shavo and John, both here from the band. And we'll take a quick break, and we'll come back, and we'll hear something off the new CD after this.
Come on, back in a minute. LoveLine is brought to you by Trojan, America's number one condom, the most trusted for over 80 years.
Line. I'm Adam, that's Dr. Drew.
Tricky continue the fight right now.
John and Shavo are here from System of a Down. Steal This Record is the this album, sorry, is the name of the CD. And we're going to hear something off it in a second. Drew is modeling some of the junk he got in the mail for John and Shavo. Drew, you said before we left that you were you talked to your shrink.
I did.
Was that on the air you said you talked to your shrink?
No, it was off the air.
Last night, here's the deal. I've been telling Drew, loves cars. Yep. Or he professes to love cars.
No, I like cars. I like thinking about cars.
He likes thinking about cars. And for, but I like cars and I buy cars.
That's right.
Drew likes cars.
You have like 9 cars.
And he doesn't buy cars.
That's right.
And for about the last 3 or 4 years, Drew's been talking to me, licking his chops, telling me about sports cars. And I subscribe to all the magazines and I start telling them in advance, Mazda's going to be making the new RX-7. That's coming out in a few months. That's like 35 grand. Looks like a decent car. It's rotary power. It's 250 horsepower. Blah, 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 blah. And after about 3 years of talking to him about cars to get, I finally realized he's not buying a car. He won't do it. And whenever I say to him, just buy a car. It's 30 grand. Who cares? You earn it. You work hard. You make a lot of money. Take care of yourself.
Spoil yourself.
He's always, my family, the kids are kids are going to private school, and one of the kids, the silver spoon that he keeps in his mouth, fell out and it got dirt on it, and that's got to be professionally clean. And you have to get an interim, you need a spare silver spoon to keep in there while the other ones are at the shop getting tarnish taken off them. So it's 2 or 3 silver spoons, and then there's the one they use when they go to space camp, and then when we go to Cuba with them, and blah 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 blah. Then the other night he starts going in about what kind of car he's going to buy his wife now, and I just said, all right, I've had an assful. You're on your own. And then I told him, talk to your shrink about why you're not buying a car.
Sounds like the only way you'll actually get something like that for yourself is if your wife buys it for you for Christmas.
That's what he used to use that, didn't you? Said something like that.
Yes, yeah, so that's what
yeah, wife throws me the keys.
I don't think you'll go out and buy it for yourself.
No, I will. I actually enjoy the preparation and stuff as much as I do. I enjoy the 3 years.
Preparation.
Anyway,
pansy.
Anyway.
3 years you've been talking about a $30,000 car.
So I went in and I said, Adam, I promise Adam I asked his questions. Here's the situation. I laid it out just the way you did. And she goes, let me see if I can recreate this. She goes, the real question is, why does he need you to buy the bachelor car?
You didn't lay it out right.
Yes, I did. Yeah, and it's like he must be feeling that part of himself slipping away. He's getting married now. He's had a big transition in his life, and he can't stand to see you fully entrenched in that whole family mentality.
Maybe he just wants you to get yourself something.
Yeah,
I'm sure you've worked very hard in the
we've
got to turn this around on Adam.
That hypothesis would be great, except for I've been laying into you for about 3 years on this subject, and I've been married for about 3 weeks.
Yeah, but it's been coming for a while, and you felt that part of you, and you can't stand to see that in me.
What are you talking about? I all I do is buy cars. Marriage doesn't slow me down.
But maybe I'm sort of symbolically that for
Well, okay.
Here's the deal.
What are you saying? Yeah.
Get a bike.
Hold on, relax.
Yeah, get a motorcycle.
Get a Harley.
Get a hog. Right. Get a chopper. All right, look, is that all you walked away with?
Yeah, that's your problem.
Mm.
Felt pretty good.
You did not represent this correctly to your shrink, Drew. That's it. Now you're walking away thinking this is my problem.
What car would you get?
Oh.
Our problem is we have lots of issues. One is that, I don't even explain this to him.
You trying to explain it to me about what issue?
How we organize this car thing. I have a leased car that's coming up in about a year and a half.
But you can have your car that you're going to drive every day.
I'm going to.
And then get something that's
dream car. Done.
That you have.
Done. No, I can't have a dream
done.
Car.
Done. 2011.
Can't it yet.
Done. Done.
2011.
Done. Please,
right, enough
Drew.
About me.
Oh, Drew, your stupid lease. He had to get the extra mileage on his lease because he was putting all the extra mileage on his car, which I told him, that's costing, the extra mileage thing is costing you as much as the car I'm talking about. You have your own car that you take in every night, just you alone. You don't have to worry about the kids. You don't need a back seat or 4 doors or any of this stuff. Now, can't squeeze the trigger. Not man enough to pull the trigger. Mark?
Yeah.
Too gay to pull the trigger. Mark, you're 25.
Oh, does that mean, I get to go on?
You're on.
You're on.
Oh, wow.
What's up?
What's going on? First, I want to say congratulations on your new marriage, Mr. Three-Weeker.
Thank you.
Hey, no problem. For the doctor, I got a question.
Mm-hmm.
Met this chick. Got her topless. She's got this spot next to her nipple, roughly about the same size as her nipple. It doesn't really look like a mole, but
third nipple.
Superfluous nipple.
Now my friends are jiving me about the third nipple thing.
Yeah, that's probably what it is.
So what exactly would that mean?
She has a third nipple.
Means she has a third nipple. We all have multiple. We have a nipple line as we're developing, and some people don't resorb them all the way.
So yeah. she could breastfeed.
I got
children.
One just. No. I got one just above my balls, in my underpants. I swear it's a nipple, but clear yellowish acidic Ew. Stuff comes out of it like three times a day.
Let me ask, if you eat asparagus, is it more yellow?
If I eat asparagus, it smells weird.
Oh my God! I know exactly what that is.
Hey guys, System of the Down.
What's up?
Went to your in-store today. I was a lucky contest winner. My girlfriend won some tickets.
Beauty.
You guys rocked. I left one of my CDs there, my best friend's band. I hope you guys get a chance to listen to it.
They were talking about it on the way in, Mal.
Whatever.
Yeah. All right, buddy.
I'll buy that.
All right, good times. Don't worry about that third nipple.
Hey, well, right on. You guys kick lots of, you know, and I hope you guys do well with this upcoming things you guys are doing with your album.
Thanks a lot.
And you guys rock on.
Good luck with the chick from Total Recall.
Hey, thanks.
All right. Hey, you know, it's right. We're going to hear System of Down some. But you know what's weird about human beings? How we get a little weird about somebody who has six toes or a superfluous nipple, extra
nipple.
Historically,
we used to get a lot weird about it.
Yeah, we used to like want to kill them and
right,
stuff.
Right.
It's just an old human biological instinct to feel weird about someone who's in the pack who may be a little diseased
right,
or different or
right,
slow the pack down
right,
somehow.
That's right.
Like
maybe
there,
that's where our evolution's going.
Yeah.
We talked about this last time
yeah,
a little bit.
There is a weird thing that if, like, in a way, it's like we're in a big pack, and if somebody shows up and they're sick or they're going to slow the pack down or they're different, like we almost want to turn on them.
Yep.
Isn't that the sort of instinct to
yeah,
turn
or,
in
or
on
maybe,
it?
Or maybe it's bad genes we don't want to be passed along.
Yeah, it's weird. It's a weird energy that when you see somebody that's has a disability, or a or they're a,
no, I
or
think
there's
it's
something
a, it's
wrong
an
with them, we want
to
turn
the,
on them.
Keep the genes in the population.
Yeah. All right, so that's a good thing. All right, let's hear System of a Down song. The Steal This Alma is the name of the CD, and this song is called I E A I A I O.
Sky.
Yeah. System of a Down, everybody.
There's some debates happening off the air.
Picking up where they left off. Drew and I arguing about cars.
So what else is new?
All right, so now you know what's...
It's not arguing, you're yelling at me.
But ironically, you know what's happened to me is I've now sworn to stop talking to you about cars for the last... Because I've been talking to Drew about cars enthusiastically for 3 years. Now for the next 3 years, we argue about cars. Drew brings up cars, I start yelling he's never going to buy one, and that's how it goes. I would, you know, I would buy you one. It's one of those cool partner things, except for I realize you owe me your career. So it would be ironic.
So there you go.
Yes. Drew'd still be making 45 grand a year and be sitting here with the poor man if it wasn't for me.
Oh,
shit. Oh yes.
Oh, no.
System of Down's here. John Shavo both here from the band. And Steal the Sound is the name of the new one. And we'll take a quick break. We'll be right back.
Hello. This is your radio. LoveLine will be right back.
Hey everybody, it's LoveLine. I'm Adam, that's Dr. Drew. System of a Down is in the studio tonight, and Shavo and John are both here representing the band. Steal This Album is the name of the new CD, and it is out as we speak. All right, let's hop back to the phones and speak to Jeff, who's 20. Jeff?
Yo, what's up?
What's up?
Hey, I'd like to say hi to Adam, Drew, and SOD. How's it going?
Good. How you doing?
Doing
What's
good.
Up?
Yeah, here's my problem. I have been going out with this girl for like 2 years, but I know like her family and stuff for the past 10 years, you know? And then last year I kind of shacked up with a prostitute. Just like slipped that in there.
Proud of you.
Mm-hmm. And so now at work, and the main thing is my girlfriend doesn't really, you know, give me anything. I have like a kissing pass and that's about it.
With your girlfriend?
With 2 years and you have a kissing pass?
Yeah.
Is she mad because you shacked up with the prostitute?
Oh, I'm sure she knows.
Doesn't know.
Yeah.
She doesn't know?
Right.
Is she a virgin?
Yes, and will be till she's married.
So you went from shacking up with a prostitute to hanging out with a virgin?
Well,
dealing with being with a virgin by shacking with prostitutes.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. No, I mean, in high school, you know, I was a ladies' man or whatnot, and then I met this girl, and I mean, she kind of like came of age and everything.
Hold on, I'm just picturing him in high school with that bad teenage mustache,
ladies,
the
man,
Italian horn the medallion hanging, and
I'm sure there's a mullet involved.
Like a three stage.
20 years old.
Probably had like a three stage mullet going with the that's the side, and then
I think
and then
we're talking
along,
to the Continental,
Champagne.
Once in a while, you see the three stager where the mullet actually steps in and then goes down a little further after it goes past the back of the neck. That's the that's a serious mullet, Jeff.
Yeah, the three stage mullet.
Yeah,
I'm the ladies' man.
Right, so ladies' man in high school. Now you're with the virgin. She's not giving it up until she's married. And the question is.
Well, now at work, I have another girl kind of like hitting on me and stuff. And
how old is the virgin girlfriend?
She's 19.
19. Mm-hmm. Maybe this isn't the relationship you want to be in right now.
Well, that's the thing. I mean, a big part of me is like, hey, this is the one for life, you know? And then the other 80% is like, you know, do it while you can.
Well, maybe you owe her more than 20%.
No.
Yeah, I think so.
All right.
How old are you?
I'm 20.
She may be the one that's a keeper, but you're not ready for that. And guys need to be ready.
Yeah.
If you get married now... And you're gonna be seeing prostitutes your whole marriage. It's gonna be a disaster.
Wow. Because I've already stepped over the line once. I mean, what's my?
There's no going back.
Therapy.
No, you could just end this relationship. It's not right for you right now.
Yeah, he got himself a virgin though.
Yeah, but
it's not right for him right now.
That's rare.
They got but you're not gonna be ready to get married for 7-8 years.
She'll probably still be a virgin when you're ready to get married.
If so, or maybe whatever she is, maybe you guys will reconnect and. Then that'll be the time.
They don't last.
Or you'll break up and she'll have sex with somebody 3 days later.
Exactly.
Out of spite.
Yeah.
And how do I be that guy?
How do you be that guy? That's an interesting thing. Yeah, you know what you should do? Here's what you should do. You should tell her you're breaking up with her, you've slept with her best friends, and you're splitting, and then just leave.
Have plastic surgery.
And then go down the street, put on a fake beard and a Sparklets man outfit, and show up at the door and like, hey, baby, where do I deliver this? And she's like, I'm going to get that Jeff back. And then you jump on her, and then halfway into it, you pull the beard off and yell, aha, but it's too late. You're already in. And she turns out to love it, like Taboo 2, you know, when she's with her brother. It's like, I've learned from Taboo 2.
Everything goes back to Taboo 2.
Yeah.
You've learned what?
Once you get in a woman and you get a few strokes going, even if you're their brother, they love it. You know what I mean?
Oh, good.
It's always like, no, no. Oh, yeah. Yeah, they can't help it, Drew. I mean, that's what I've learned.
Oh, my God.
Brother. Yeah, your dad. Then you'd ever. Imagine me hearing this in hi-fi stereo.
I want to see the family. I want to look at the family while I'm hearing this.
Yeah. You see that?
Which is Junior? This one?
Yeah,
that's Junior on the cover.
That's Junior on the cover.
And that's the mom and the sister.
Yeah, yeah.
Sister's fine.
Oh, my God.
But you don't. That's sassy. We got to do Taboo 2 the musical.
That'd be interesting. I'd go to see it. And I'm not into musicals at all.
Come on, but let me say this. You know, ever since The Who stopped cranking out musicals, no popular bands crank out musicals anymore. Maybe you guys ought to bring that back. You start with, Taboo 2, and then, like, your second one is something called, like, Falafel, that's about an Armenian restaurant. I don't know. It's just off the top of my head, but you know
what I'm
saying?
Big Fat Greek Wedding. Didn't that start as a musical or something?
Yeah.
It's beverage.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's goat-based.
Yeah, this is my song.
Is it Zanku? You're doing Zanku?
No, cannot have.
Is this the Zanku one?
No, yes. Cannot have.
Let's hear it. Let's
no, 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 you cannot have. No, no mixing. No, cannot have. Read menu. No, no, get fired. No.
Get fired.
Yeah.
Where did you go? What Nazi Zanku did you go to?
Because that night.
No, cannot. No, no, cannot. No!
Yeah, I sample System of a Down.
No,
wow,
no,
that was long.
Cannot have. No, no, no. Cannot have. No, 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 no. Cannot have. No, no. Cannot have. No, no, no. Cannot. No, no. Cannot have. No, 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 no. Cannot have.
I don't think I've heard the whole one in a long time.
Me neither.
Yeah, that's my singing Armenian waiter. Yeah, it's great.
But now, listen,
there's great parodies of our stuff out there. Have you?
Oh, really?
Tenacious D does a great cover of Chop Suey.
Really?
Yeah, it's amazing. It's like the music comes on, he's playing it on acoustic guitar, and then it's just gibberish.
Uh-huh. Well, you know you've arrived. I mean, when you're starting to get the parody songs roll in, like maybe Weird Al cannot be far around the corner.
I heard a rumor about that, but I don't know what happened.
Really?
Yeah.
You guys would be cool with that, right?
Yeah, oh, why not?
I'd be very cool with it.
All right.
No, this is like,
there's like a lounge one going on. The album's called Toxicity instead of Toxicity. Toxicity. I saw it and I heard it too. It was really great.
This is like 1975, right? When you say something like that?
Maybe 80? 70.
I think 80.
80?
Yeah, it could be 70.
So about close to 25 years ago.
Yeah.
So these guys are all, they must be in their 50s now.
Oh, that guy's still doing movies.
Really?
Junior?
Yeah. Yeah.
Drew, come on. Don't ruin it for me tonight.
But I mean, I would just wonder what's going through their minds about what they decided to do when they were 25.
Oh, Drew, you see any pictures of you in high school in the yearbook?
It's horrible.
Yeah, what was going through your mind?
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah, but I'm ashamed of that.
Good. You know what that's what I'm saying.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, but at least they were in
the art. That's
the
art.
That's the best era of porn right there.
That's right. They were caught in their prime. Nothing wrong with that.
If you're going to do porn,
do a classic.
At least there's classic there. I mean, real film.
Yeah, they look.
Storylines, props. I mean, it was shot in people's homes, real nice decor.
They look back on this, like I imagine, like Joe Namath would look back on his playing career.
Or you,
you know
yeah, you
saying?
And your high school football days.
That's right. Mm-hmm. Nothing wrong with that. Mm-hmm. Kathy?
Yeah.
Except for I'm not beating off to Joe Namath and winning a Super Bowl.
Not anymore, anyway. Not now. This.
That's right. Kathy, you're 25.
Yeah.
What's
I have
up?
A couple of questions for you. Mm-hmm. First of all, the taint. You know, it's called the taint.
Mm-hmm.
What is the correct term for that?
Perineum.
Hernium?
Perineum.
Perineum.
And really,
okay.
Technically, don't the girls have a taint?
What's a taint?
Well, the taint's got it between the nutsack and the anus.
Right.
It's a divider, you mean?
That area there. But if you don't have a nutsack, I'm not quite sure if you have a taint.
But you have perineum.
Okay.
Okay. Okay, and then also, you know how you guys are always talking about the hymen?
Always talking about it, yes.
Always.
That's all we talk about.
I was wondering, like, if you have a bruised hymen, how can they really tell, like, if it's already been broken?
Yeah, they don't
is
actually.
Is there, like, a rim or something left?
Yeah, they don't bruise. They're just not there anymore. Just more open.
What if it's, like, a younger child?
Has a hymen ever been bruised?
No. Not bruised.
Not bruised?
Does your boyfriend have a really small penis?
No.
It's bruised. It's just kind of bruised.
My younger child, I know.
Yeah, she has a dented hymen.
Yeah.
What happens when you were a child?
Not a younger child I know, she's 5, and it happened to her a long time ago, and they said her hymen was bruised. And if it was broken, we were wondering how can it, you know, does...
No.
Yeah, not bruised. You know what they mean? They mean that's like when your ego gets bruised. Like if a guy turns you down sexually, he's like, your hymen got bruised. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. It's an emotional thing.
Sweeping the nation, that saying, by the way.
Yeah. What's the matter, sweet pea? Bruised hymen? I can pick up the pieces. All right.
Can rip it.
System of a Down is here tonight. We'll take a break. We'll be right back.
Okay, so I know there's nothing wrong with me. So what's up?
So I was like you, and I used to think that these datelines were totally cheesy.
Why can't I meet anybody?
But I tried everything else and thought, what the hell? So I called the dateline and actually met a cool guy.
I called the dateline and I hooked up with some cool people.
Believe it or not, other normal people are out there looking too.
877-889-DATE.
LoveLine. 1-800-LOVE-191. We'll be right back.
Buddy, it's LoveLine. I'm Adam. That's Dr. Drew. John is here from System of a Down, and Shavo is here from System of a Down, except for I'm not sure where Shavo is.
Shavo's probably in the bathroom.
But as soon as Shavo emerges from the bathroom, we'll come on out here and
hey,
join
I didn't
us.
Know you guys had a urinal installed right here in the room.
No, we just mic'd up the one that's down the hall. There's Shavo. And the new CD, by the way, is called Steal This Album and is out as we speak. All right, I'm going to have to go again. Casey?
Yeah.
Go ahead, Casey. What's up?
Oh, I had a speaker come to school today, and she's was bringing up different birth control methods and all that kind of stuff. And the last one she came to was pull up.
Mm-hmm.
And... she was talking about how, why they say, you know, if, you know, not to use it and all that kind of stuff, but that there's some big, you know, misconception about how the pre-seminal fluid is why you shouldn't do it for the main reason.
Mm-hmm.
And she went into saying that that is not what carries the sperm, you know what I mean, that it mm-hmm. doesn't always have it in it.
That's true.
Okay.
It doesn't always have it in it.
Okay.
But Drew, you always say there's
But there is some evidence that sometimes it can be highly concentrated in sperm.
See, that's the first thing that popped into my head was, you know, you in the back of my head going, but wait a second.
Yeah, but it's controversial, uh-huh. but you don't want to take that risk.
Yeah.
Well, can't someone figure this out?
It's probably some people have and some people don't. You can't predict when it's going to be there and when it's not.
Mm-hmm.
Well, she brought up the other fact that before a man ejaculates that there's like... But some men have between like 2 and 3 like spurts
mm-hmm.
is what she referred to it as. And I was like, okay, these are things that have never been brought up to me or that I've never really
2 or 3 spurts of what?
Of semen.
Before their sperm.
Or canola oil.
But the spurts that are sperm free?
No, that are sperm. Like before the, I guess you call it the load. You know what I mean?
The load.
The load is coming all the way.
Yeah, is that the industry term?
The load. You mean contractions before something is emitted? Is that what you mean?
Yeah.
I guess. I mean.
Well, no. Here's the deal. spurts would suggest something
coming out
of the penis.
I think that's what she was trying.
No, I think you're talking about contractions before the spurt occurs.
Yeah, it's like when you vomit.
Yeah.
You know, when you vomit, you go, like the third one, it all comes flying out of you.
It's when your penis vomits.
Right. Yeah, so if you feel that, thing, like if you feel the balls doing a that means it's
hey, there's something
slide out.
Else interesting just came out this week, a vaccine for certain wart viruses, for the certain of the genital wart viruses, the ones that cause cervical cancer. So we may be getting close to eradicating genital warts.
So wait, you just you get the shot.
Hell yeah.
You wouldn't be able to do any if you already had it.
You got it. So far no way to
Have to get this shot.
To get the shot if you don't have it. And there are several different viruses that are associated with cervical cancer, but the one big one they now have a good vaccine against.
Yeah.
Can't you just sand them down or something?
Yeah, it still causes the cancer.
Take a Dremel or Digrind.
It is. This vaccine looks really good. It's going to be revolutionary, I think.
All right. Good times. Hey, Casey?
Uh-huh.
All right. There you go, baby.
Okay, thank you.
All right.
Thank you for paying attention. That's good.
Yeah. What the hell went on in that class?
Let's ask what they told her about the morning after pill.
Did they say anything about the morning after pill?
She told me was that here on the Central Coast that she just got the license that the health department around here to give it out as like a prevention thing, because not a lot of people can get to where it is.
But did she describe to you how it works and that kind of thing?
Oh, that you take one within 72 hours and then another one 12 hours after.
But should she talk about the misconceptions around that pill and how it works? No. Okay.
True. It's a pop quiz. Leave her alone.
Well, I'm just curious. What's RU-47 and how people confuse all that with the abortion pill?
Right.
Where do you go? Okay, you go to public school?
Yeah.
Wow.
Well,
progressive.
I have parents that tried to educate me on all this stuff a long time ago.
You're a good student, right?
For the most part. I kind of screwed off the first 2 years, but,
all right, but you're back
I got
now.
My act together.
Yeah. See, like, if you would have asked me what went on after an assembly and when I was 17, I would have, like, a dude had shoes with buckles. Queer. I don't know what he's talking about. I don't think he's talking about either. She's talking about birth control and the Holocaust. I can't remember, but the dude had gay shoes. Oh, man, I couldn't stop staring at him.
I lost the headphones.
All right, let's talk to Nick, who's 17. Nick?
Hey,
what's up?
I've listened to the show for a long time, since I don't know when. But every Thanksgiving, you always talk about your cranberry sauce.
Right.
How you hate it in the can.
Right.
And I've been, like, waiting for it, and I haven't heard it.
Well, I want to avoid this sound.
I saw three sacks of cranberries sitting in our kitchen. I was so proud.
Really?
Yep.
Is your wife going to? Your wife's going to.
Oh, she cooks like
Remember the year you tried to lie to me and tell me your wife made fresh cranberries? And then you start backtracking and saying, well, maybe it wasn't fresh. And then I called her and she didn't make it.
She bought it fresh.
You lied.
She bought somebody else's.
No.
But now I got the cranberries sitting there.
Okay,
so
well, let me give you the recipe. But here's the deal, and I'll clue in John and Shavo. I like cranberry sauce. I like fresh cranberry sauce for the Thanksgiving. I like everything fresh. You know, I don't want a canned turkey. I don't want canned stuffing or green beans. Everything you make fresh. But people don't make the fresh cranberry sauce. They just open the can. They think that's good enough. To me, unacceptable. And fresh cranberries, very easy to make. You know, you buy a sack of cranberries. I need to go to work for, like, the cranberry education board, because I talk to people about this all day, and they're like, what's a cranberry look like, and where do you buy them, and how do you do it?
Little cherries.
Yeah, cranberries look like little beans, and they're little red beans, and they come in a sack, like Ocean Spray sells them in a sack, and all you got to do to make fresh cranberry sauce is open that sack into a little saucepan, put in a cup of water, and then put in, like, a cup of sugar, and put the lid on
it. A full cup?
Well, that's what the recipe calls for,
okay,
Drew.
All right.
Seems like a lot of sugar, but cranberries are very tart, you know?
Yeah, I'm in.
Here's the way I do it. I start with maybe 2/3 of a cup of sugar, because I like it a little on the tart side, and then you can always work in a little more sugar, seasoned to taste, as they say.
Throw any walnuts in there, anything fancy?
I don't like getting crazy with that stuff, but I will put a little zest of lemon or a little orange or lemon rind in there.
And you simmer
adds color,
you
makes it pleasing to the eye as well as the palate.
I see, yes.
You see?
Yes,
you guys cook cranberries, or what do you guys eat?
So weed kebab.
Wait.
Really?
No.
You guys get down with the Thanksgiving, of the course. Turkey and stuff, right?
Wait, do you boil it? Do you simmer it? Do you let it cover
it? Put it on at just a medium heat.
For how
put
long?
The lid on the pot. Until walk away. 5 minutes later, done.
5 minutes.
Cranberry sauce. People think it's going to take a few hours. No.
I think it's
done.
Time that people took a stand.
That's what I'm saying.
On something.
Yeah, take a crayon. That's going to be part
there
of the...
There you go. Well, bumper stickers will be all over the country tomorrow.
Take a cran stand and cook fresh cranberries this year. And Nick?
Yeah.
All right, so you going to do this? Because I'm doing it.
Of course.
My family tells me to bring it. It was a little rough 4 or 5 years ago when I popped up the Tupperware thing of cranberry at Aunt Pat's house, and she gave me the stink eye because they're like, what, is my cranberry not good enough for you? And I was like, I'm just covering myself. I like fresh cranberry. And there was a little tension at the table, but then everyone dug into my cranberry. And all was forgiven.
Now, how are you going to do Thanksgiving this year? First marriage year? Well, how's this going
to
work?
I got to go to the crazy in-laws' house and then over to Dad's house.
Dad's house?
Yeah.
And
yeah.
What time are you going to be at the in-laws' house? Like early?
I don't know. 2:00? Like 3 o'clock. I just sit there and she talks about the Bible.
Why don't both families come together?
No.
Oh.
No.
Oh.
That's I don't need that. No, it's enough. It's okay. Enough spread apart.
And then you, at your house, will your stepsister and all the step family?
Yeah, they'll be there.
The ones from Oregon?
Somewhere around there. They move around a lot.
How many years did you live with those people?
My stepsister?
Yeah.
I lived there for like three years.
Where did this fascination with taboo come from?
No, I'm wondering what went on there. But I'm just curious. I met his family at his wedding, and these are all people I've never... There's a whole sort of... wing of his family that lived in the same squalor that he did that he never mentioned.
Well, they didn't live in the squalor because they didn't come into the family until the last couple of years.
She had your garage.
She lived in the garage, yeah.
And then she complained that you could even get in to use the bathroom when she couldn't.
Are you kidding? I used to get locked out of the house. I couldn't use the bathroom. Why was I crapping in a decorative popcorn tin if I could use the bathroom? My Aunt Pat and Uncle Vince gave me. And by the way, no worse gift for an 18-year-old. Hey, we bought you a tin of popcorn. Oh, fantastic.
Let's see. This could do a second as a toilet. Okay. Right.
This is the same aunt and uncle that got me each year for my birthday. They would send me the little card that had the slots in it, and they put a dime in for every age you were, and it's great. 14. Let me do the math. $1.40. Let's see. What could I buy? Well, I could get into half a movie. And once I'm in the movie,
candy bars.
I could buy like one candy bar or half a soda. Oh, that's great. That's great. Change. You're sending your nephew change? Oh, what kind of thinking is that, Drew?
Did you crap in the tin till it filled up?
No.
Just halfway.
You'd empty it every time?
Yeah, I'd empty it. Well, because the problem is it got too heavy to carry. I had to roll it out. No.
What do you give them for the holidays now?
Nothing. I give them cranberry sauce. That's it. All right, so everyone make your own cranberries. That's what I'm saying. And
Take a stand.
Make the cran. Right.
Yeah.
And cook it up fresh. It's very easy. Very easy. And it's delightful. And you know what's nice? When you make a sandwich the next day, you get the white meat, spread that out on the bun.
Genius.
And then put a nice layer of cranberry on top of it. It makes it very moist. Helps the white meat go down. Cecilia?
Hey.
You're 14?
Yeah.
What's up?
Hey, guys. I was just wondering, like, what Ariel's was all about. Like, what would you guys, like, write it about? What is it, like, based on?
Don't really explain our songs ever. It's open to your interpretation.
Well, like, yeah, but, like, okay, then, what's the video about?
Video?
Yeah.
We don't really explain ourselves. Really explain it's kind of open to your interpretation.
Sort of like...
Hey, can I tell you a
trapeze
story?
Trapeze artists.
I'm going to tell you a story right now. True story, okay? You ready?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
No, I'm just kidding.
I know.
Today we were doing a signing here in L.A. I don't know where you're from.
San Diego.
Well, we were doing a signing here in L.A., and we found out at the Tower Records that we were at that they put Serge's book. Serge has a poetry book called Cool Gardens.
Mm-hmm.
They had it in the gardening category at the Tower Records.
I didn't know about that.
That is good.
That's really cool.
Back to your topic, though. We don't really define our songs. But if you want Serge's book, go to the gardening section at Tower Records.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right.
All right.
I love you guys. Okay.
We love you too.
Bye.
Take care, baby. Let's talk to Dan.
Hi.
Dan, what's up?
Hey, what's this Taboo 2 I've been hearing about?
You're not a believer yet, are you?
This is the world's best pornographic film.
Really?
And not movie, film.
Should have won the Oscar, I think. Really should have. For porn. If there was one, it would have won it.
That's
where
right.
Where can I get it from?
It's the Michael Jordan of porn.
Yeah, I'm not so sure other people will sort of experience it with the same delight that you
do. Oh, they better. They better.
It was your sort of primordial experience of porn because you were 11 when you were exposed to this.
No, I wasn't 11.
14,
I was
18, whatever. You were. You know,
no, I was like 18, and I met the Wheez, who's my buddy who actually had a VCR in his room. And I never knew anyone who had a VCR because I hung out with losers, and my family was a loser. And he had a VCR with Taboo 2, and so that's the one I watched, and then we fell in love. But the movie holds up. It's a good film. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Let me give you another example. You ever seen Watership Down? You know what I'm talking about?
Mm-hmm. No.
It's a cartoon, basically, based on a book. When I was a kid, I watched this, and I thought it was the most amazing movie ever.
Mm-hmm.
I watched it about a month ago. I got it on DVD. I wasn't impressed.
Right.
Taboo, I watched it as a kid. I thought it was the most amazing movie ever.
Mm-hmm.
I watched it yesterday, and I was still just as impressed as I always was.
That's right.
It holds up to time. It's like Gone with the Wind. It's always going to be a classic.
It's like falling in love all over again each time you see it, Drew.
My God.
It really is. It really works. And the music is great.
I want to see the scene where your famous song is sung.
You need to. You know
I
what?
See that part.
I'm going to give that to you.
Oh,
we'll get Adam another copy.
No, Jack.
Let him borrow it after next week.
No, that's right.
All right.
For one day.
All right. You borrow.
Watch
it.
The movie. I'm going to call you and give you a quiz.
I want you to watch it from first.
Forget The Shining.
I can't believe you haven't seen The Shining, though.
I know.
I can't believe
it. You'll be shining your dork when you see this.
Yes. You'll pull up in a Porsche, let's put it that way, at the end of that movie.
It's like, cut to 3 weeks from now, Adam's in the hospital, he's been low on fluids and electrolytes, he's hooked up to an IV, he's lying, he's incoherent on the bed, he's catatonic, but he's hanging on to the Taboo 2. Yes, Drew slides into the room with his white coat on, says, I'd like to see the patient, he tries to pry it from my half-dead hand, I cling to it, he won't let go of the DVD. Drew. That's how you can get it for me.
We need to release the penis now, Mr. Crowley. We got to sew it back on the body.
Yes. Adam, you can no longer stroke the penis when it's not attached to you. Let the doctor sew it back on. Mary?
Uh-huh.
You're 16?
Yes.
What's up?
Hi. I usually, wax my bikini area, but, this weekend, I wasn't able to, so I had to shave it.
Mm-hmm.
And then, I did that on Friday. Then Friday night, I had sex. And then, on Saturday, I had, a really bad, rash.
Yeah, that's just from the shaving. Probably.
Well, no, because, it's also, broken out, where, I didn't shave at. And I've never had, razor burn that bad before.
And it's on both sides?
Yeah.
Where you didn't shave at?
Hmm. Yeah, well, I don't know, if razor burn can, spread or
Does
whatever.
Does it get inside the vagina at all?
No, but, it's,
Well, there's a couple possibilities. One is that it is still some sort of folliculitis, an infection of the hair follicle, which can kind of spread around a little bit. Or maybe a herpes.
How's that gonna spread around a little bit if there's no shaving in that area?
Because staph, it just moves.
Really?
Yeah, it spreads.
Really?
Yeah, a little bit. But yeah.
Or it's herpes, you know?
Or it's herpes.
Yeah, it's either a razor burn or a herpes.
But would herpes kick in that fast?
Usually not, but it sometimes does come kind of quickly.
Yeah, that's
folliculitis or herpes, right?
I didn't think that it could happen that fast.
It usually doesn't. It usually doesn't.
Because the next morning.
It usually doesn't.
Oh. Okay.
It's probably just still related to the
okay, thank you.
And what should she do to it?
Neosporin, something like that. Actually,
really?
If you get Bactroban ointment, that'd be the best thing.
They sell that?
No. Prescription.
Why? Because it works?
Yeah.
What's the danger in that? Okay, but can you look into these things, Drew?
There was a huge article about sort of examining this, why certain things and how to get things more.
I scream at Drew all the time. Why the crab shampoo? Why does that need to be a prescription item? You know what I mean?
Isn't it the same thing that you use if you have lice?
Yep.
Yeah. And they got one that they sell over the counter, but it doesn't work. And then there's one that does work, but you got to get a prescription. And I argue that a lot of people, especially young people, they don't know where. They don't have insurance. They don't have a doctor.
They don't want to talk to their
parents.
About that, yeah.
They don't want to go talk about crabs.
They want to go to Shame On.
that's our new drugstore idea. This is a drugstore cool. that only caters to people who have sort of dicey sexual problems. You get your herpes medication.
And this will be our sign.
Shame on.
Yeah. We'll use the Taboo logo. Yeah, you go there, get your crab combs, all kinds of stuff. In a judgment-free environment. That's what I'm... That's where the real sale is.
Shame on.
Mike?
Yes?
You're 33?
Correct, yeah.
What's up?
I heard you guys like several months ago talking about this, and I don't know if it's been brought up. I've caught the tail end of it. My penis is slightly bent to the left.
Mm-hmm.
And I know it can't be that bad. Maybe like 25, 30 degrees. I'm not sure. Anyway, the problem is the upper third of the right side of my penis gets bad friction burn every time I have sex. Hmm. Whether I use a condom or don't use a condom.
Interesting.
Normally I use a condom.
All right.
Hmm. And what happens is... most of the time, I can't have pain-free sex again for like another week.
Uh-huh.
And sometimes even longer than that because it takes time for it to heal.
All right. Well, here's you want to straighten things out?
That's what I don't know. Is that what I need to do?
Well,
pardon the pun.
If it's something like a Peyronie syndrome where you have a little scarring on that left side that's pulling it over to that side, vitamin E, 800 units a day, will help that out.
Not really.
Yeah, it does. It actually does.
Take it through the mouth?
Through the mouth. Vitamin E, 800 units a day.
Okay. I do take... 400 units of vitamin E plus an aspirin a day and a men's one a day.
You need a little more, 800 units
okay.
a day.
Yeah, and don't count on this work.
It may not work. It doesn't look like it's not at the tip. It's not like a complication of your circumcision.
It's right below the tip is where it starts.
Yeah, so
it could be a circumcision problem.
Yeah, sometimes
right?
the circumcision scarring pulls it over to one side too, and that's a little bit more difficult. There are surgical procedures to release and repair these things. Most of them involve taking a piece out of the other side,
I'm not
open
about
end.
This. I'm taking the headphones off.
Yeah, yeah. And bringing it back up, but that kind of shortens things a little bit. Most guys don't like that.
So it's kind of like chopping down a tree.
Right.
Yeah. I never had a complaint from a woman as far as it being curved too much, and I never had a problem with sex. And
are you circumcised?
No, I mean yes, I am circumcised.
All right.
Yeah.
All right, so you got a little gooseneck on the on the wiener there. A little dog-like.
Said it was better.
All right.
Neck on the wiener there. Uh-huh.
All right. Well, I don't know
Yahoo.
What we can. I don't know what we can do about it. How about a little more lube?
That's what I was thinking.
That doesn't seem ever to be the problem. That's
how long are you having sex for before the irritation?
Eight
occurs?
Hours.
How long are you at it before the irritation develops?
How long is I at? Oh, you mean like how many years did I have sex?
No. How long are you having sex in a session before the irritation develops?
Depends on how tight the woman is, to be honest with you. Usually, I don't know, maybe upwards to 20 minutes.
Come on, be honest.
So 20 minutes in, the pain starts.
But yeah, I never time it.
All right, so finish earlier.
You got to finish earlier. And let me say this. What about a little skid plate on that part of the penis? Like here's what I'm saying. I know it sounds kooky, but like I've been watching, I watch a lot of football, and I noticed this year in the last couple of years, a lot of guys when they're playing on the AstroTurf, instead of wearing elbow pads, they wear these sort of almost sort of X-shaped bandages that just sort of stick on their elbows. They don't want to wear elbow pads, but they don't want to get scuffed up on the turf. And obviously, this is some sort of surgical adhesive stuff because it ain't peeling off. You got guys sweating and grinding their elbows, and it's not peeling off.
They put it on the skin.
Put it right on the skin.
So they don't burn when they hit the AstroTurf.
Kind of looks like a patch.
Yeah. That would feel good on the penis and real good on the vagina.
You know, why don't you just do it sideways?
It off will be fun.
Just have sex sideways.
Yeah, you go.
Then it's going to angle the way it's supposed to angle, and you'll be all right.
Or you get with an Asian woman. Because the...
Oh, my God.
Didn't you...
Why?
You know what they say.
No, why?
Oh, true. You know, it goes the other way.
It's not true.
Oh, really?
That's what I hear.
Oh, really? That's interesting.
I remember I was talking to Minka about that. She said it was true.
The uterus tips the other way?
Yeah, the whole thing is tipped over on the side.
The vagina goes the other way.
Yeah.
Number one.
Yeah, don't you know anything?
No, I guess not.
You never studied that chart.
No.
You
got to
stick with me.
I'm with you.
All right. System of a Down is here. John and Shavo both from the band, and we'll take a quick break. We'll be right back.
Love Line.
1-800-LOVE-191.
We'll be right back.
Loveline. I'm Adam Carolla. That is Dr. Drew over there. John and Shavo both here from System of a Down. System of a Down, our favoriteest band. And System of a Down we knew them when they were just pups, and their success has been just amazing. And System of a Down seems to have fans. What are you doing, Drew?
Did that work better? You're hearing out of both ears now, finally?
Yeah, I think so. That's good. Thanks, buddy. System of a Down has fans. I think their music sort of speaks to their fans on a little more than just a melodic level. Mm. Like, there's a lot of people who sort of identify with the feelings of the music or the imagery that is conjured by the music. I mean, it's powerful. It's not just you're listening to it because it's catchy. It's more like this is evoking some energy or reaction
some primal,
or emotion.
Primal emotions.
In me. You guys must notice that.
Yeah, I mean, we're playing live, we do.
Yeah. But, I mean, just in terms of like, when you showed up today, all those kids out there.
There's an incredible energy. When you see people crying just because they meet you, it's
right.
It's pretty incredible. We don't really understand it. You know, we're just
The band, I think the band has a sort of energy that your fans pick up on. I mean, there's a sort of, it's not depressing, but it's a serious and it's sort of almost important kind of energy that people pick up on. And
we have it.
Yeah, you have it. And you don't, it's weird. You don't need to know what the song's about. You don't need to hear the lyrics. You just feel, what the tone is.
Should we hear a song?
Oh, yeah. Well, that's a good idea.
Yeah.
Since you're talking about it, nice little segue.
Yeah.
In our app.
I
want to hear
it.
I want to hear it since
very much.
Drew's right. Drew's right. Steal This Album is the name of the CD. Anderson, you ready to rock? This one is called Inner Vision.
Well, I have a home longing to roam. Signs on your face, slowing your pace. I need your guidance. I need to seek my inner vision. Inner vision. My pupils dance, lost in a trance. Your sacred silence. Losing all violence, stars in their place. Mirror your face. I need to find you. I need to seek my inner vision. Inner vision. Inner vision.
It's a little bit. It's getting close to the canned cranberry sauce. And then
it's a little sweet.
Yeah.
Why? What are you talking about?
He's talking about they're not fresh baked yams out of the oven.
No, you can do them. All you right. Do them up with.
You put a little cinnamon on top, some brown sugar.
You don't have
some
to
marshmallows.
Do canned yams.
All right. Okay.
Not that I would ever do anything.
No. No, but
house would burn down.
I'm gonna start cooking though soon.
System of a Down is here tonight. By the way, we're just talking about what we're gonna be eating in a day and a half. Oh, do I love that Thanksgiving? You know what I love about Thanksgiving? It's got all the good stuff of Christmas without the part where you forgot to get someone a gift, or you don't have to deal with that.
Like cleaning up the Christmas decorations.
Yeah, dragging the tree around and stuff. This is just about eating and getting loaded.
Yeah, and watching football.
Yeah.
Who plays on Thanksgiving? I think
Detroit. I mean, traditionally,
Lions play.
The Lions play like the early game. It always seems like the Packers, Detroit, and I'm not sure who plays at the late o'clock, the late game. Brandon.
Yeah.
You're 14?
Yeah.
What's up?
I just wanted to know, who do you like more, Minka or Taboo 2?
Oh, man. That's like Drew choosing between his kids. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah, like he couldn't do it. You know what I'm saying? Right, Drew?
Couldn't do it.
You don't have a favorite. You love them both.
All.
I mean, all. Whatever. What do you got now?
Three.
Three? You love them all. You leave them threes. Thrice. All right, Brandon? Don't make me make that decision, man.
Okay.
All right. Yeah, I mean, like if I was, like, hanging off a cliff and I was holding Taboo 2 in one hand and Minka in the other hand, she's the number one Asian big boob queen.
John and Minka is. Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Anderson, play a little Minka. Play a little Minka. Yeah, she's a delight, this woman.
Number one, Asian big boob queen. Number one.
I think I heard her when she was on the show. She was on the show, right?
Yeah. She has like a silly string inside her breast or something. Drew, remember she was talking about that?
She attacked you in a strip club or something?
Yeah, she did, yeah.
You know what you guys never mentioned, though? Maybe you didn't see it. When she first got in here, she was walking with that dog on her chest, Chihuahua, and she was not holding the dog. The dog was just propped on her boobs.
Oh really? God.
She had both hands at the sides, and the dog was just up there.
Oh, yeah. I missed that.
You see? You say they're impractical,
utility,
Drew.
Yeah?
Yeah. Yeah,
it's like cabinet space. It's
like a monkey's tail or something.
Yeah, you don't need a leash. Yeah, she's like a marsupial.
Yeah.
Keeps the dog in the pouch.
You ever seen Upstairs, Downstairs? Seika, who else is in that?
Oh, I thought you were talking about the PBS series.
No.
Yeah, it sounds like a
it was a series on PBS. Yeah, Seika and who?
Who's that redheaded chick?
Oh, Lisa DeLue?
I don't know, but she's like irritatingly loud.
She's got big hands?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, I know her work.
What about that?
Another classic just popped into mind.
Oh, God. Well, John got a CD burner now, so he's
DVD
dangerous.
Burner.
I mean, a DVD burner, so look out.
I'm taking all the VHS stuff and putting it on DVD.
Smart. For the kids.
It's not all available. It's you know, we want to keep it for, you know, right. Nostalgia. Keep it
sure, real. Sure. Troy?
Yeah. Church.
You're 26?
Yeah.
What's up?
Well, I got a question for Drew. Mm-hmm. See, I'm trying to have anal with my girl, but she's refusing, so I'm wondering, you know, can I give her, like, a medical reason that it'll be good for her so she can do it?
Yeah.
What's that?
Yeah,
if you don't do it, I'm going to beat your ass.
Tell her, until she ends up in the hospital. No, tell her it helps, Drew, what?
It transfers vital fluids.
Yeah, like, you're going to it's like an IV. Like, you're gonna pass some fluids to her this way.
Tell her you're going to check her temperature.
That's it?
No, Troy.
Drew, what do you got? You have any
no, it's not
any advice for Troy?
There's no benefit to that behavior.
Oh, that blows.
Yeah. She won't let you do this, Troy?
Nope. She refuses to give it up.
That's all right.
How long you been with her?
I've been with her about a year now.
Mm-hmm.
And that's a deal breaker for you?
Yeah.
What does that do for you?
None. I just want some anal.
Well, what about... what? And Troy sounds like a big boy too.
Yep.
You big down there, Troy?
No,
he's big all over. How much you weigh?
I'm 6'3", 325.
Okay.
Yeah. So if your penis weighs what, 8-12 pounds?
Nah, not even.
No.
That's how much my dog weighs.
All right. Hey, Troy. Here's the problem with this. I understand you want this, but if you talk her into it and she doesn't want to do it and she lets you do it,
forever.
She'll resent you for the rest of her life.
That's right.
Plus, you might crack her in half.
That's the problem. And do you like her? Do you love her?
Yeah, I love her.
But, Troy, help me understand what that does for you. Just for my own understanding. Why is that important to you?
It doesn't do nothing for me. It's just something that I've never done, so therefore I'm...
Well, there's a lot of things I've never done that, you know... I don't particularly have to do.
That's one thing I feel I have to do.
Why? What is it? What does it do for you? I'm just curious. What is it that it's?
No, it's like watching it on porn. You know, it seems like something fun. Mm-hmm.
All right. Well, listen. I got a great simulation. Troy, you listening?
Yeah, go ahead.
All right, here's what you do. You take a jelly jar, and you cramp in it. Then you duct tape a bagel to the top of it, and then you rape it. All right?
You heat it up?
Oh, my God. Put it in the microwave. Well, I'm just saying that is a reasonable simulation.
Can you use dog poop? Is that all right? There's lots of that around.
Yeah, I think the texture's a little different.
Yeah.
Just go to your house and find that popcorn canister.
And here's the deal. Don't make the mistake I made and leave it in the microwave for like
2 minutes.
Two minutes because it'll catch on fire. Oh. Yeah.
I made?
Oh, the cleanup's horrible.
Yeah, just give it a warm up. Just give it a warm up.
10 seconds max.
That's right. That's right. All right, let's go vomit. Let's go vomit.
Forget about Thanksgiving.
Yeah. You guys want to go vomit? Anymore,
talking about yams and cranberry sauce tonight. You're talking about bagels and crap.
Bagels and poo.
Sounds good.
Yeah.
Great show.
Let's. Oh, Sit Down is turned on the show now.
I don't want to talk about crap.
All right. Well, no more.
No more crap.
All right. Let's take a little break. Let's get our crap together. We'll
Mr.
Right
Hanky.
Good. Thanks.
Hello. Is this LoveLine?
Call 1-800-LOVE-191. Adam and Dr. Drew will be right back.
Dr. Drew, John and Shavo here tonight from System of a Down. Steal This Album is the name of the new CD. It is out. It is out today. And got a question for the band here. Nick?
Hello?
Nick, you're 16. What's up?
What's up? My question was, what's your first music video going to be?
On this album?
Yeah.
Probably Inner Vision. I'm not sure. Cool. That's a single right now.
Yeah, and you have a nice bong.
Where?
On the Tucker special CD thingy.
My bong's there?
Yeah, it was on the video.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know.
Good times.
All right.
Great. Thank you.
Hey, Nick?
Yeah?
You looking forward to see the video coming out?
Yeah, but I'm not going to watch it on MTV or anything. I'll just download it because MTV's pretty crappy.
Yeah. You got to boycott that MTV now that we're not on it.
That's the man.
Man's bringing you down.
All right, well, you download it, yeah?
Other videos.
Yeah.
All right, forget
that fresh cranberry sauce either.
Okay.
You like cranberry, Nick?
Make that one.
Yeah,
don't download
like
that.
Canned one.
You used the canned one.
I'm sick of that word download at this point.
It's child really abuse.
Not thrilled with that word anymore, download.
Yeah, someone could do better. We could do better than download. Mm. I'm not sure what it
doesn't
is.
Sound
though.
Good, download.
Yeah.
Copy?
Nah. Someone's got to come up with something better than download. I'm going to work on that.
It's bugging me.
Eileen?
Yes.
Yeah, you're 30?
Mm-hmm.
What's up?
Well, I got a kind of a funky... All right, we were having sex. My partner was... we were using a condom. Mm-hmm. Kind of a, you know, trusted naming condom type of thing. With the spermicide. And it's... stretched out to like twice the length when he came.
What stretched out twice the length?
The condom.
I mean, because he had
condom.
Because there was so much fluid, or just because it was sort of.
It's, because he was so little.
Twice
the length. How does it ever stretch out twice the length? It's usually too short.
It was freaky because we used the same condoms we've always used, and
stretched he only has out. One condom, but he keeps using it. The
same one.
Hey, if it
same
ain't one. Broke.
If it ain't broke, don't change it.
Well, we just got out of the washing room. We can't have sex for 3 more hours. It's not dry.
I'm a little confused. The fluid, the volume of fluid stretched it out to twice the size of what it was before?
I think that must have been what it was, and I'm just wondering if it was like a faulty thing. I don't know if this, I've never had this happen before.
And what did it look like? Did it look like, you know, when you're a kid and you would run around the house in your socks, and after a while the sock would be hanging 8 inches off the front of your foot? Did it have that look to it?
Tube socks, right?
Yeah.
Well, you know,
you've
like
been burning normal. Out on the hardwood floor for too long. Yeah.
Well, like normal, there's a little, you know, reservoir or whatnot at the end when you're finished, but it was like twice that length.
Well, maybe the whole thing just slid down.
Yeah.
Oh, he said he was freaking out because it was so, because he said it was so stretched out, and I was like, right. Well, maybe.
It didn't leak though, right? Didn't break. Didn't break.
What's that?
It didn't break.
As far as we know, no. I'm just wondering if it was like an old one or something, or it, you know, if it had.
Hard to tell.
Take a closer look when you get it back from the dry cleaner.
Yeah, yeah, and you know, Eileen, you should use a new one every time. And the old one, you just tie off the end, you swing it around your head, and you throw it at oncoming cars.
I'll try. We'll
I have tied the ends
before.
Yeah.
I've thrown it at.
That's nice. Right, yeah. Yeah, like a water balloon fight, but for adults. Kevin?
That's funny you say that.
You're 25.
Yeah.
What's up?
Kind of make a knot.
First time, man. You guys are great.
Great.
Check it out. I had sex with my girlfriend for the first time last weekend. We've been
Hey, me too. Just kidding.
With his girlfriend?
Yeah.
No, we've been seeing each other for like 3 weeks, and she had like a zit, like on her labia.
Mm-hmm.
And the reason I figured that it was a zit is because like I've had that same problem like in the past, like when I was like
on your labia.
Right.
It's not a zit. It's an infected gland usually.
Is that bad?
It's not for you. It's bad for her. It'd be uncomfortable.
Okay. Because I've had the same thing on my penis before.
Well, that's more of a zit type. That's a carbuncle, basically. But they get infected glands. Sometimes they have to be lanced, opened up.
It's different for women than for
men. Yeah.
It's a different thing.
And let me explain the lancing process. They don't actually pierce it. A guy named Lance nails them until it pops. All right?
They call that lancing, yeah.
I'm sorry, but sometimes it's confusing to the listeners, Drew. All right. So, Kevin, she's all right. She should go have it checked out, though.
Use hot compresses in the meantime.
Okay, so the women can't have acne down there?
No.
Really? Okay.
See, Kevin is...
Kevin, it somehow you put the word acne on it, it's okay for Kevin. But you say an infected Bartholin's gland, it's like, oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, my God.
No, I think it was one of these things where Kevin decided it was something.
Yeah.
And he's going to hang on to it now.
Yeah, probably discovered it when he was going down on her.
That something
right.
is okay.
Got poked in the eye.
And any of the names unaccepted is not okay.
I was wondering, like, is that stress-related? Because...
No.
Not at all?
No.
Why, is she stressed out?
Well, no, just because I've been, like, I was stressed out on girls in the past, you know, by the time I got to that point, like, you know, I've always had, like, different things going on down there, you know?
No, what are you talking about?
Well, like, this one time I had, like, it was, like, 2 days, you know, beforehand, and I come down with jock itch, you know, after not being laid, you know, for so many years, you know?
Well, you just happen to have gotten jock itch.
Kevin, let me ask you a question. Are you pre-med? Yeah. I'm just playing a hunch here.
Did you see a falling star or anything that same night?
No, I'm educated, that's all.
Really? Where?
Junior college.
You junior college man?
You want to know?
Junior college, right?
Well, yeah.
All right. Yeah, I know junior college when I hear it. All right, buddy. You should sue that college.
All right, I think I will.
All right, buddy. Hey, lay off the weed. You're smoking too much weed.
No, I don't.
Oh, come on.
I don't get weed from him.
I'm getting weed from him.
Right.
It's a residual effect.
All right.
All right, buddy. All right, she's fine. Take care of yourself. Right. I wasn't quite sure with his... He was stressed out about not getting laid, and then he got jock itch 2 days later.
Well, after not getting laid for years.
It's like talking to primitive man. It's like, you know, I have sex... Then moon changed phase.
Yeah. I saw a raven, then the volcano erupted, so the raven must have caused the volcano to erupt. Yeah, it's talking to primitive
man. That's pretty
man.
Much how it goes, though, right?
Mackenzie.
No, that's what I'm saying, yeah.
19.
Mackenzie?
Yeah?
What's up?
Okay, I've been with my boyfriend for a little over a year, and when we first started going out, we could, like, never keep our hands off each other. Mm-hmm. And now it feels like a chore when I have sex with him. Mm. I was just wondering, like, what I could do to make it fun again.
What do you think the problem is?
Excuse me?
What do you think the problem is? Why did it get boring?
I don't know. It's just,
A little bit of the little girl voice going here.
I don't know. It's just, it feels like I have to have sex with him.
Because
and, like, I really love him. I love being with him. Mm-hmm. But it's just the sex. It's not fun anymore.
Yeah. Mm. Was anything ever happened to you growing up?
No.
Nothing? No abuse or anything?
No.
All right. Well, maybe you're not. We talk to women. This happens all the time. They're sort of falling out of love with the guy, but in their mind, they're still into the guy because it's like, no, he's a great guy, and he really cares about me, and he treats me right, but your vagina's telling you differently.
Right.
You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, maybe you're losing your feelings for him intimately, like as a boyfriend.
Or, yeah, that she is, but maybe it's by virtue of sabotage. Maybe she had... Did your dad leave the family when you were young?
No.
He's still with you?
Mm-hmm.
Are you a close relationship with him?
Yes, I do.
Is this boyfriend you have now, is he objectifying you in some way or making you feel sort
is
of...
What?
Objectifying you? Is he making you feel like he doesn't really pay attention to you, your feelings, just sort of interested in sex and that's it?
Well, like, I don't know. We're really different from each other. Mm-hmm. Like, we don't like the same things.
All right, here we go. You're right.
So, like, and then I'll, like, want to have, like, sex in all these random places, and he's just like, no, no.
Yeah, I think your vagina's speaking clearly.
Yeah, put it on the phone. Let me see if I can. No, you may. It's been a year.
Yeah, it's been a little over a year.
Yeah,
19. That's about.
Sounds like you're kind of coasting to a stop.
One thing
this
about being 19 is you don't know when relationships are over. You're not used to looking at the signs. You're not used to bringing them to a close. You don't know what how to do
You have no experience ending a relationship and knowing when one is over. And you know, Mackenzie's not really arguing with us too much either. Like, normally when we bring this up, people are like, no, he's great. He's great.
I've actually been thinking about that, though. I don't know. This has been my longest relationship I've ever had.
I know, and it's hard to leave those.
And, like, he's, like, talking about getting married and stuff.
Yeah, you're not into that. You don't want to do that.
I don't know if I want to marry him.
No. Don't go to marriage where you don't know.
Poor guy's listening to the show. He's putting a pistol in his mouth right now here in Drew. All right. Mackenzie,
you're 19. It's normal to go out and have other relationships, all right?
Mm-hmm.
All right.
There. Like yeah, have a great holiday breaking up with him. That's great. So he's great.
What's better yet is get through the holiday thinking the whole time, man, this is,
I'm gonna drop the accent. Yeah. Nothing worse than getting dumped around the holidays. Oh.
I broke up with a girl Christmas Eve once.
Oh, really? Yeah.
Pretty messed
up. Pig.
It had to happen, though.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. That's.
I was in love with someone else.
Bad times.
No, that made it easier.
Yeah.
For me. I don't know about her.
Bambi from Taboo, too.
Mm-hmm.
We'll take a little break. System of Down here tonight. We'll be right back.
All right, guys. Bottom line, here's the deal. Looking to hook up?
Sick of wasting time with the wrong person? One call's all you need to make. Call the Dateline. The Dateline.
877-889-DATE.
LoveLine with Adam Carolla and Dr. Drew.
1-800-LOVE-191. Wow, wow, wow. You can feel, you say, wow, wow. You can feel, you can.
We'll be right back.
Oh, where did the time go, everybody?
It always flies.
Well, when you're having fun and you're with friends. I want to thank John and Shavo for coming in here tonight.
Thank you.
Always.
It's always fun having you.
Always,
here.
Always fun. And let's get out to lunch or dinner or whatever we got to do as soon as we can do it. And I'm going to watch this Taboo. Maybe in my car tonight.
You hear the album.
I'm going to say you're not going to make it home.
All right. Steal This Album is the name of the CD. System of a Down. Always good to see you guys. And until next time, this is Adam Carolla for Dr. Drew saying mahalo.
Thank you.
Lesbian. You hear that?
No, I'm a girl.
This has been LoveLine. The opinions expressed on this show are not necessarily those of the staff, management, sponsors, or this station.
The producer for LoveLine is Ann Wilkins Engel.
LoveLine is a presentation of Westwood One Entertainment.